In this segment, we are going to introduce you to the adequacy of linear regression models. So for example, somebody gives you y versus x data, and they want you to regress it to a straight line. All you need to do is to put in the values of x and y into these two formulas and be able to find a0 and a1, which are the intercept and the slope of that particular straight line. The question which we have to ask is, how do we know that this straight line regression model is adequate? So here we are showing the same data as I showed in the previous slide, but in some context here, that data was actually coefficient of linear thermal expansion of steel as a function of temperature. And here are the 22 data points which were in that graph given to us in a table form. And we can use those particular data points to be able to draw this linear regression curve. The question arises, how do we know that this straight line regression model is a reasonable fit and that's adequate? So whenever we try to look at the quality of fitted data, we always have to answer these two questions. Does the model describe the data adequately? Which simply means that whether the model which you have drawn, is it acceptable to you? And the second thing which we must answer, or the second question we must answer, is that how well does the model predict the response variable predictably? What that means is that, let's suppose we're given a value of, we're given y versus x data, and we have already gone through the regression modeling. We want to be able to figure out that, hey, how well does the y get predicted once we have chosen a particular value of x? A word of caution here, we are limiting our discussion to the adequacy of straight line regression models, and we should not simply use this to also answer any questions about the adequacy of nonlinear regression models. So there are four checks we have to talk about, but keep in mind that the adequacy of regression model is not limited to these four checks. For example, there's an F-test that can indicate whether the linear regression model provides a better fit to the data than a model which is just a constant line. That means that if there's no dependence on the independent variables, is that as good a model as the linear regression model which you've drawn? But let's just talk about the four checks which you can make, and you'll be in much better shape than most people who look at regression models. Most people who look at regression models, they only look at check number three. But let's go and talk about these four different checks, and in your ensuing videos, you will see each of these discussed. First, what we need to do is we need to check visually the data and the model itself. Does the model look close to the data points? How does it visually look to you? The second one is that we need to see if the scale residuals, which are basically based on the residuals which you get for each data point, which is the difference between the predicted and the observed values, and it is normalized by something called the standard error estimate. And we want to find out whether those numbers for the scale residuals are between minus 2 and plus 2. The next question is that, hey, how close does the coefficient determination come to 1? And then the last check is to see that whether the model is meeting the assumption of random errors. So if we make these four checks, we'll be able to at least talk about the adequacy of linear regression models. In the video that you're going to see after this, you'll find out that, hey, we're not taking all the 22 data points, but we are only taking 6 data points. The main reason for doing that is to keep the algebra simple. We still have 22 data points, but we're taking 6 data points so that we can show the algebra for all the first 3 checks which we have. For the fourth check, which you're going to see, we take all the 22 data points because it'll be inadequate for that case to show only 6 data points. And that is the end of this segment.